Kristen Braddett, I need help. I watched all your bonker videos and tried to execute, but my dog gives zero fucks. I'm trying to stop barking in the house and a lot of other stuff.
Okay, so if your dog doesn't care about the bonker, you most likely deployed it wrong. Your timing was probably wrong. Did you say no first? Did you say no at the beginning stages of arousal? Did you do a pre-bonk? There's many other ways to do it. For barking in the house, just get a bark collar. Get yourself a bark collar. But as far as like everything else, massive structure. So do massive structure. We've talked about it on every single video. As far as like, imagine if your dog came to the board in our boarding train, what would it do? First thing it would do, go into a kennel, come out of a kennel, wait at thresholds. We'd work on sit, down, place. Then we would add duration to it, make things non-negotiable eventually. No free roaming, cut down on affection, work for your food. Next.
We're live.
Now we're live. Yeah! Nice. Hey everybody, how are you? Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. And this is what we're going to do. We've got a Q&A podcast. Hit your refresh screen. See what happens. Okay. All right. Stream quality is really, really low. So that might be affecting it, guys. We got a low, I don't know why we got such low stream quality here. There it goes. Now we're starting. All right. Hi everybody. How are you? It is the What Would Jeff Do show. It is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, and I've got a special co-host. This is Zoe. Zoe is next to me, and Zoe is our latest intern in the intern program. They're here for 3 months, and she's never spoken in front of the camera before. She's never been put in the hot seat before. She doesn't like to talk in front of the camera. So, she's like, I'm like, hey, I need you to do the podcast on Monday when Joelle's out of town. She's like, I'm like, okay, great. That sounds like a yes to me. So she's going to read the questions. I'm going to give the answers. We're going to make it really, really easy. If you're brand new to my world, I'm sitting right here in Providence at our training center. We're based in Providence, Rhode Island. I do tour the world doing dog training seminars. So I've got the seminar series, the podcast, and the training center. Now, let's talk about the training center. At the training center, we rehab very challenging dogs. But also, check out our Instagram. What did I put up? The daycare video that you took today? Oops, sorry. The daycare video that I took today? Of all the dogs. Did I put that up on both platforms? I took it up on both platforms. On both, yeah. So Facebook, that's like a 22-second video or something. That shows our daycare, which is like highly structured. We do daycare. We do boarding only for client dogs. And then our board and train program, which is mostly what we do, is for dogs who are really struggling. We deal with some highly aggressive dogs here, a lot of leash reactivity, a lot of human aggression, dog aggression, a lot of separation anxiety. And then obviously, we do basic and advanced obedience. We're balanced trainers. So at the training center, for instance, when we're training commands, we use food and clickers. Okay, so let's scale this, please. So I'm actually going to make a how-to video on a new how-to videos on basic commands. I think people are going to be really surprised that we do about almost 500 repetitions before we actually introduce the word no. Now, my weekend seminar series, by the way, I'm going to be in Alaska. I'm going to be in Anchorage, Alaska. Not this weekend, but the weekend after. Really excited about that. You can go to jeffgelmanseminars.com, jeffgelmanseminars.com, to get tickets to any of my seminars and to see my seminar series. But I'm doing 25 of them a year, and then I do the podcast. Now, seminar series, massive problem solving. People bring me dogs, and they want me to stop stuff. You can bring any dog you want, and they're all in the room together. Like the dogs that you see in daycare from that video, if you want to jump on Instagram, if I knew how to use this technology properly, this technology, we actually can put that video up here now when everybody can watch it. Oh, I need you to figure out how to do that and talk louder. Okay. All right. So, and the podcast, you're going to notice that most people are going to ask me, hey, Jeff, how do I stop? How do I stop? How do I stop? So most people on this podcast ask me how to stop a unwanted behavior. So the only way to do that is by applying an effective punisher. Now, you can call it a correction if you want to, but punishment. So reward increases behavior, punishment decreases behavior. Simple stuff, right? So what do? where we use, you can do anything that's effective, but bonker, which is a rolled up towel, believe it or not, it's one of the most effective,
don't have one here,
tools that we've got, remote collar or shock collar. I use the word shock collar, leash and prong collar. So that's what we're going to talk about, but there's more to it. Every single question that Zoe asked me pretty much needs like a 5-week boarding train, 6-week boarding train, or at least a 1-hour Skype, but where you're going to get yourself a quick answer to sort of, you know, to just get you going. And then I want you to start looking at my whole body of work. Many people have totally off-leash trained their dogs from free content that we have. All right. There's also something called Top Chat. There's a little dollar sign down at the bottom of your screen underneath your comments there. Your question gets queued to the top, but you do not have to pay to play. I will answer as many questions as possible. This is a 90-minute show. So how are you? You'll be able to navigate the screen pretty well?
Yes.
Awesome. So let's start right up at the top and ask the first question.
Britt Gamble, the other day I got my German Shepherd to down for a minute by passing cars. It was nice.
Awesome. Super proud of you. This is the thing. Well, you edit a lot of this stuff now in the background.
Yes, I do.
So you see the progress that people are making.
Yes.
Really impressive. It's just so impressive that you did that. Kudos to you. Next.
Melissa says, good evening.
Hey, Melissa. How are you? So Melissa is the Melissa who works for us. Good.
Michelle Anderson, good evening. Jeff and guests.
So this is Zoe. Michelle is our number one YouTube commenter. Nobody's made more comments, positive comments. Trust me, there's many people out there that comment a lot more, but they're number one, but we use a different finger for those. I wouldn't, but Linda, my wife, would. Next.
Diana Vong.
Yep.
Hi, Jeff and guests.
Hey, her name is Zoe, but that's okay. So we're going to call her Zoe, all right? If you can't pronounce a name, don't worry about it. Next.
Diana also says, do you have an updated protocol for separation anxiety? My dog is crate trained, but inconsistent. Some days he's fine for 4 hours. Some days he starts getting anxious in 2.
So what I want you to do is definitely watch the separation anxiety video on there. We're making all new how-to videos. But what you're going to do is you've got to set your dog up. Set it up. You have to leave the house. I mean, I don't want you sitting outside for 4 hours. But what I always like to tell people is, what's the rest of the day look like? So we have dogs that don't do well in the crate and end up doing well in the crate here. Why? Because of how we work them out of the crate. Lots of structure everywhere. Don't just be like willy-nilly and then all of a sudden be like, oh, now you have to go in a crate for a bunch of hours and behave. Don't be willy-nilly in the house and then expect your dog to do a perfect walk, right? So a lot of people are letting their dogs bark out the front window, but then when they go for a walk, they're like, I don't want my dog to bark. It's like, well, your dog's sort of been practicing it. Next.
She also said, haven't been able to leave home, have an e-collar and bark collar and correct when I need to, but again, inconsistent.
So again, that's the advice you're going to get on the show. You can always do an AMA on Instagram stories. If you're not jumping on our Instagram stories, guys, you might want to do that. Always schedule a Skype. But listen, I'm not here to solicit, you know, business at all. Just remember this. What's the rest of the day look like? Take that and run with it. Next.
David Smith, and the co-host is Zoe.
Zoe. David Smith is probably the first person that Joelle... I'm just like going down memory lane with you. It's like David Smith is probably the first person that Joelle lost her shit over.
Why?
In a good way. Not yelling. Just like totally laughing. It's a story about a turtle, which we are going to find, and you will be editing it. Next.
Ron Becca.
Let's just say Ron. Yep.
Thank you for both. Thanking you both for all that you do and for dogs and people too.
My pleasure, Ron. Thank you so much.
Diana
says, if you can't remember, do the last, just say anything. Yeah.
Diana says, hi, Zoe. Hi.
Hey.
Melissa says, hi, Zoe. Hi, Melissa. Michelle Anderson, hello, Zoe. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you too. Chris, paper team, love you guys. So grateful for all the free content and everything you do. It's amazing stuff. And my Great Dane is immune to e-collars, electric fence. He will just lay in it. E-collars, 100, nothing.
Okay. Check for fit. And I don't know the brand and I don't know your timing. Also, what you want to do is get your... There's more to life than e-collars, by the way, also. Like, you can fully train your dog without one. Why do we use them? It's a great way to communicate with the dog close by and up to a mile away. It's really good for state of mind stuff. Also, it helps owners leverage lack of training ability, even though you do need skill set to work a remote collar. Next.
Alexis Hine, how do I get my dog to pay no attention to the neighbor's dog barking and growling on the other side of the fence?
So what we do is, a classic fence fighting thing is this. We cannot control the world, right? So there's always going to be dogs barking. Always. What you're going to do is, the best protocol that we have found that works for us, as well as my fans, I give this advice out all the time, remote collar on your dog. Let your dog out in the backyard. Let it act like a jerk at the dog at the fence. Use the remote collar at a level that is going to be high. It should be uncomfortable. The dog goes, that sucked. Now, does it suck more than the pleasure the dog gets from barking, which is really enjoyable? That's the goal. So the dog will control the number. Next.
Jane Robinson, when I've put my dog in down or place, must I use the brake command, or can I use here if I'm further away?
You can do anything you want to. What you can do is this. This is our philosophy. Brake means now you're free, or recall, which means come to me. So you don't have to say brake, recall. You can just go, you can go from sit, down, place to recall. Next.
Kaylee J, good evening, guys.
Kaylee J, we met at a seminar. She has the most whining dog, even more than Joelle's.
Oh, my gosh. Yes,
but we love her. Next.
Kayani and Zeke, hey, guys, good evening.
Hey, how are you?
Have to talk good louder. Evening.
Yep. How are you?
Joseph Pequin, hey, Zoe, Jackson, and Stella, miss you. Miss them, too.
Oh, is that your family?
No, it's Jackson and Stella, the little
puppies. Sorry. Yes. Oh, how are you?
Rose Bros Dog Training. Hey, another one. Your favorite critic turned student here. How do I market to the right qualified people? Everyone wants my training, but a lot of them want cheaper prices.
Right. So Rose Brothers, a little history about him is he hated me. So many people start out hating, but so many people still do hate me.
I hated you.
You hated me too, right? Yeah. Yes. Did you really?
Yeah.
Nice. I fucking love you. That's right. That's awesome. That's really great to hear. This is it. Cheaper prices. This is what you do. Make tons of free videos. First of all, you could. I don't do discounts. I have two prices, free or full price. That's it. I do $100,000 a year in pro bono work. $100,000 a year. I do tons of free training, and that doesn't count. Probably if I monetize, if I put value to all this free advice on my show, we're talking about literally like training. So, what I want you to do, Rose Brothers, is how many how-to videos do you have, right? Are you doing a Q&A show? Are you doing an AMA? So if you don't have enough money, you can always do it, but don't do a sale. I can't tell you how many times I see an Instagram, ad or page saying 30% off boarding trains this week. Are you serious? I fucking just went to you 2 weeks ago and I paid full price. How dare, I feel terrible. Next.
Magic Larry, good evening, Zoe and Jeff. Good evening.
Hello, hey, what's up?
Diana, do you have a specific brand of crate you recommend for strong 100-pound Doberman?
Well, strong doesn't mean it. If he's a crate breaker, yes, you want to get the strongest one there is. They make some really strong metal boxes. For crates, most of the dogs, we've got commercial-grade crates, but your average dog will go into a wire crate or in an airline crate. Next.
Scatterstorm. Hi, guys.
Hey, how are you, Scatterstorm? Thanks for sending me that, I think, an IG message. Next. Hey, anyway, speaking of IG messages, if there's anybody out there that's watching this show from your laptop, your phone, especially the big screen, your dogs are in down or in place, do a little scan, do a little picture, put it up on your stories, tag us at Sally Canine Training, and bam, we'll be putting it up there. So, if you want to know what Zoe does, one of her things is in an internship is she works on Joelle's social media team, and she's starting to kill it. What's the latest video that we published of yours?
The bear go home.
The bear go home?
Mm-hmm.
Pack walk. I think we put up less than six still of your videos?
No, more.
More than six?
Yes.
Oh, really? That you've done exclusively?
Yes.
Oh, we're talking about you've done the short clips too.
Yeah,
too.
Yeah. But more.
Awesome.
Big ones.
Good for you.
Chris Paper Team, how do I start by fixing the separation anxiety without an e-collar? Client doesn't believe in it.
That's the wrong client. So if you believe in it and they don't believe in it, it's the wrong client. We only work with clients that align, because we're success oriented. This concept that, you're a dog trainer, you should help every dog or work within their parameters. No, you should not. As a professional dog trainer, it is your obligation to do what works, what you know works best, not what the owner is most comfortable with. It's the way it is. They want results, but they want to dictate. To me, that'd be a not. So I can't answer your question. I would say that becomes a non-client. That's my answer. It's a non-client. Tell them to figure it out themselves then. And that sounds anti-client, but no, it's not. And there's many people out there that are like, I can fix a separation anxiety without a remote collar. So can I. I can train a dog with a shoestring and a treat bag. Well, why don't you, Jeff? Because that's an ego-based statement. My clients can't. Next.
Lynn Wilson, hi. How do you teach heel as a position from whatever they're doing to get to your left side? Mine knows how to heel perfectly as they walk along, not how to start out. Makes sense?
So yes, it does. So call to heel, recall to heel, swing finish. We don't do that. So what you can do, it's a recall food protocol. It's not that difficult to do, but none of our clients need that. None of them ask for it. And guess what? The dogs we get in, we got bigger issues for them to be working on. In the sport dog community, watch their videos. Next.
Cheyenne and Zeke, yesterday my family and I went to the beach and I realized how stupid I am. The whole day Zeke was wearing his e-collar and I forgot to turn it on. The entire time I thought it was on. He did great though.
That doesn't make you stupid at all. That makes you fucking smart, hardworking, and a badass. Next.
I lost my sight.
Yep, that happens every once in a while. You get bumped.
Yep, all the way. Karen, GSD lover. Hi, Jeff and Zoe. Just saying hi.
Hey, Karen. Super fan. Next.
Kristen Braddett, I need help. I watched all your bonker videos and tried to execute, but my dog gives zero fucks. I'm trying to stop barking in the house and a lot of other stuff.
Okay, so if your dog doesn't care about the bonker, you most likely deployed it wrong. Your timing was probably wrong. Did you say no first? Did you say no at the beginning stages of arousal? Did you do a pre-bonk? There's many other ways to do it. For barking in the house, just get a bark collar. Just get yourself a bark collar. But as far as like everything else, massive structure. So do massive structure. We've talked about it on every single video. As far as like, imagine if your dog came to the board in our boarding train, what would it do? First thing it would do, go into a kennel. Come out of a kennel. Weighted thresholds. We'd work on sit, down, place. Then we would add duration to it. Make things non-negotiable eventually. No free roaming. Cut down on affection. Work for your food. Next.
Liz Edwards. Oh, $5
top. $5 top. So then you click on that, read that, and then get out of there.
Rose Dog Training. Do Q&A about once a week. Last Q&A was on how to fix issues. A lot like this. I believe I'm the highest price around. How much content a week?
So now you get out of that or you get stuck there. Yes. Okay. So being the highest price around. So how much you can't put up too much content. Rose Brothers, you cannot put up too much content. Add massive value to the marketplace. Now you can start doing some targeting ads. You can start targeting ads. That's not my level of expertise. I actually have somebody that does that for me. You start doing targeting ads. You can start making sure that you're tagging certain things with certain demographics. You can start getting people to the right people to your page. Always be working free dogs. Always be working free dogs. I mean, if you're slow and your prices are at the top of the tier, you might be overpriced. Frankly, I'd rather lower my prices and be busy all the time. Right? Next.
Liz Edwards, I have a doggo who had a bit of resource guarding issues with balls while playing fetch. I just got a pup who's learning to fetch. How do you deal with your dogs and fetch? I have seen them all.
So I've got high drive dogs. Most of the dogs that I have, they don't fight ever. So resource guarding is easy to fix. It's a 3-second procedure. I can fix resource guarding quicker than I can teach a sit, and I can teach a sit really quick. For the pup, at the beginning right now, I would do fetch with the pup. Pup, first of all, might not care about the ball unless it's a high drive ball, high drive dog. Don't ever let them fight over it. Because that could turn horrific. If the pup keeps getting bullied right now, once that pup gets to maturity, it's going to go to the dogo and say, you know what? Fuck you. And you know how you've been picking on me? But now I'm bigger, I'm stronger, and I know how to use my mouth. So you want to advocate for that dog. So sorry I'm picking my nose here, guys, but I have an itch. What you're going to do is, if you want to do two separate fetch things, and then see how that goes, and then do it together, see how that goes. Next.
Katie Hi, Jeff. I was on last week and asked about discounted seminar tickets. I emailed, like you said, and haven't heard anything. You said you empty your email each day, which is why I'm checking.
So I respond to every single email. Check your spam file. Check. Email me again or PM me on, just PM me. PM me. I'm easy to get a hold of, but not by phone. I actually don't answer the phone, but I make lots of phone calls. But I responded to everybody. All right, so try it again. Next.
Emmett K., good evening, Jeff and Zoe. It's me with Bentley the Beagle. We have been practicing heel and a lot on our walks.
Awesome.
Bentley has done good, not reacting to humans / dogs.
Awesome.
But some dogs, he goes from 0 to 100 in a second.
I know, and you know what? Your dog has got many years of practicing. Hold on.
I tried to correct him with the e-collar 2 to 3 times, and it doesn't faze him. We are doing something wrong, not high enough on the e-collar.
Go up higher, most likely, or your timing is not as good. Next.
Julie, hi. Good evening. Jeff and Zoe, good evening.
Good evening. How are you, Julie?
Josie, fearful, anxious GSD mix with leash reactivity, using prong and e-collar, and trying to figure out how to stop arousal. Stem sometimes escalates. My timing method and level of correction must be wrong.
Correct. Your timing is, so there's you can add fuel to the fire by literally shooting your dog up. It happens all the time. Most people don't correct with arousal at the very first sign of it. We're talking the very first sign. Sometimes you have some dogs, you have barely a window to do it. The smallest window. If you miss that window, boom. And for all the folks out there, they're like, oh, redirect with food. You don't work dogs like we work dogs. The dogs we work with are not going to be redirected with food. We have dogs that will blow through 100 on the remote collar and still be leash reactive. And not because of the discomfort, it's because that's how bad they want to get to the dog. So there's a very, you can do the pre-walk bonk, the pre-walk punisher, but also, I'm going to keep saying this, what's the rest of the day look like? Are you holding your dog accountable for small things, such as your dog does it down, and then all of a sudden gets up and moves 2 feet and lies down there? Well, that you didn't tell that dog to lie. You didn't tell that dog to do that. Right? So what's it look like? Next.
$20 chop chat from Tokage.
Tokage, yes.
Tokage got the dog on double boss now, and he keeps himself together again.
Awesome. Proud of you. Yep, double boss. That's it. Tokage is, you know, he's got some skill set, and that's what it took for Tokage. Next.
Liz Edwards, playing fetch, and I know they're pretty high drive. Do I need to enforce having separate toys for them? And does this apply only to balls or all toys?
You're going to know. It's your journey. It's your dog. I'm not there. I don't know. So with my dogs, they tend to have separate toys. They pick a toy and they use it. My dogs don't have toys. They play fetch or they go swimming. They tend to stick to the same ball. Next.
Amy, tips for minor lingering leash reactivity towards dogs only. Have been troubleshooting, huge improvement, but still some lingering hiding behind my knees, nervousness. Grr, thanks.
Okay, so the hiding behind your knees is a good sign. Your dog's going into avoidance, which is really, really good. Let the dog do that. Allow the dog to do that. Some dogs will want to switch sides as well. Let the dog do that as well. The dog is saying, you know what? Lunging is not a good option anymore. Getting closer to my owner or moving back behind my owner is a good option. So what you want to do is continue to do that or put your dog into what we call avoidance for now, because it seems like your dog is the most successful that way. Next.
She also said, P.S. I love you guys.
I love you too. I love all of you guys, by the way. And guys, thank you for all the wonderful support that you've been giving me these last couple of weeks or the last week with all the nonsense going on out there online. It's pretty bad. But I don't publicly talk about it. I made one post, but you know, if we have time at the end of the show, I'm going to read something interesting. Next.
Emily Morgan, when is the best time considering overall health and training to neuter a GSD? Is 1 year safe?
I don't know. Wait, so say that one more time. When should we de-sex the dog? I'm not a vet.
I don't know.
Next. Earlier, people do it way too early. That's all I can say. Next.
Julie, how do you know if your dog has leash reactivity or dog reactivity?
You would know. You'd know, right? How do you know when you got a bloody nose? You'd know, right? Leash reactivity is your dog, you're walking your dog, and your dog explodes on the leash. That's leash reactivity. You would know. Next.
Madison Allen, when do I decide to stim versus leash pop while on structured heel walk?
All depends on your skill set. All depends on how well the dog understands the tools. We start dogs on prong, but getting them on that remote is going to be your best bet. And then also do it always at the beginning of the sequence. You're going to hear me constantly say, give information to your dog at the beginning of the sequence next, because it's no information next.
Ron, please explain what kind of emotional fallout does a dog experience emotionally if you do a bad job with a bonker?
None. Zero. None. Dogs don't get emotional fallout. You can do the crappiest job in the world with there's no such thing as bad bonking. You can be the worst bonker in the world. There's zero emotional fallout. None whatsoever. That's called imagined harm. It doesn't exist. I've never seen it. Nobody has ever seen it at all. That's a human's interpretation, or that's a lie. I'm not yelling at you, by the way. I don't yell at anybody. I'm just passionate as fuck. It doesn't exist. It doesn't exist. Everybody thinks you're going to fuck up your dog. Okay. We work with the most, quote unquote, messed up dogs out there. Dogs that are ruining people's lives. Dogs that are aggressive. Dogs that are reactive. Dogs that are massively separation anxiety. Dogs that self-mutilate. Dogs that, like, get into dog fights. Dogs that have killed dogs. Bit children. Dogs that, like, don't know any commands. Dogs that have pulled their owners down the street and broken bones. Broken noses. Guess what? None of them have been on these tools before. None of these tools created any of these issues. Everybody's afraid of using the tools wrong. Can you? Sure. Of course you could. But look where you are now. So take a chance. Next.
Conrad Miller's, good evening from Alberta, Canada.
Hey,
is
Canada.
Is it possible to stop heavy panting in the crate?
Yes. Remote collar low level. We do that with one of the dogs right now. Blue.
Beverly Herbert, female dog approaches dog with dominant body language of tail high, head high, ears forward, etc. Should I correct before it escalates? No growling or teeth showing, mouth closed.
Yeah, wait, who's is it her dog or a dog coming at her?
I think it's her dog.
Her dog? Oh, yeah, you better correct your dog immediately. Next.
Steve, hi, when using a prong collar, which direction is the ring supposed to be facing, the ring where the leash is attached to?
Everyone's got a different, different preference. Some people like down in the middle of the back. I like it on the side that you're on. So I heel dogs on the left, so I want it coming out of the right side of the neck. Next. That's just my personal preference. Next.
Steph Gons, I love you guys. Best training. My dog's name is Zoe. Ha ha ha.
Look at that. And this is Zoe, by the way. It's her first time on the show. Joelle is on vacation. We're not allowing her to do anything. I'm doing the social media.
Did you guys tell that it's him? There's a big difference.
Fuck you, Zoe. Are you serious?
Yes, me and Ben were talking about it.
Are you serious?
Tell, yes.
Yeah, no shit you can tell, but you had to throw it out there? You had to throw it out there.
Yes, I did. She also said she barks like crazy when we leave her in the crate and we leave. Bark collar doesn't seem to work.
You're using the wrong type of bark collar, or it's the wrong fit. So the bark limiter or the e-collar technology. Next.
Aldo, good live quality.
Awesome. Good. Yeah, my stream. For some reason, we just had a new box installed here.
No, it's horrible.
It's fucking horrific.
Yep. It's bad. Internet's bad. Upstairs, too. Sometimes.
I would expect it to be when you're far away from the router, but you ain't that far away from the router.
Maybe it's because we're all connected to the same one, because I think everybody connected to 5G instead of, like, the solid cable.
You shouldn't be on 5G upstairs.
Yeah, no, I'm not.
5G is only for, like, this perimeter right here. Mm-hmm. You should be on the non-5G. But still. Next.
Megan Vance, welcome, Zoe. Doing a great job. Thank you.
So Megan Vance is turned into a fucking rock star. I'm proud of her. Megan Vance finally got out of a relationship that she was in that she shouldn't have been in. I've been yelling at her. She's finally bought a house. She's moved out. And I'm really, really super proud of her.
Congrats.
Is that Ben?
Yeah.
Ben, that door is driving me nuts.
That was Harold today.
Someone's got to fix it. And then also, can you check to see what's going on in the back?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Xavier Ortiz, what size and brand long lead do you guys use?
Doesn't make a difference. Use any leash you want to. Use a piece of rope. Next.
Diana, love your content and all that you do. Thanks so much. Also, can you attend your Saturday walks if they have a reactive dog with e-collar and prong? We love to drive up from New York for one.
Yes, you can. I would suggest doing it on a week that I'm doing the walk. Not to say that the other staff can't help you, but It is. It is. We run a tight ship. I don't do every walk. Like this weekend, I'm doing a walk. So what you can do is you can always email the office, find out when's Jeff going to be in town doing a walk. You absolutely can. Next.
Scattered storm. Do you guys list some confidence building activities that could help decrease dog fear? My dog struggles to pay attention to me when there's another dog in the area. He's nervous and unsure.
You just need focus work, but you for to go over, under, through for confidence. But I would just work on becoming more valuable to your dog. Become more valuable to your dog. I would try a 180 move. Just different healing exercises. Just training in general. Next.
He also said, Zoe, you're doing a great job. Thank you.
And she, Justin did a super chat for $2. I still say get some rest, Jeff. Joelle listened. Yeah, well, who's that? Justin, I love you, man. I'm doing 18-hour days. That's what I do. I love it. This is how I am, man. This is how I am. A lot of people need my help. So I'm doing the best I can here. Next.
Julie, do non-structured walks help a dog's confidence if she's allowed to go sniff as long as she isn't pulling and follows heel if we stay it?
You can do anything you want to, but we don't do that. But meanwhile, I'm not against sniffing, but not when you're on the walk. But you can take a walk break, but it's a mixed message to your dog. But giving your dog a casual walk won't build confidence. Next.
Kristen, why is my female dog such an asshole to other female dogs, but put two males in the room and she's better? What the fuck?
I don't know why. I would say I'm not there. I have no idea. Next.
Kaylee J, LOL, yes, and we are kicking the whining in the butt over here.
Awesome. Proud of you.
Maylene, major reactivity and aggression with anyone jogging by and especially on bikes. What do we do?
Well, number one, I don't know your skill set. So what I want you to do is this. I also don't know what the tools you're using. And I don't know your skill set with those tools. So for starters, prong collar on your dog, remote collar on your dog, for starters. Teach your dog how to walk on those tools with no distractions whatsoever. That's how you start. So get really good at that. Can you get your dog to walk properly next to you and not even look around with no environmentals? Then start introducing easy environmentals. Then, as your dog starts loading or getting aroused around the big environmentals, you want to shut it down. Next.
Missy Jackson, happy I caught another show. Can't wait to attend seminar. My 12-and-a-half-year-old husky mix whines incessantly. My fault all those years reinforcing it without knowing it. Tried bonker, not consistent. Result, any advice? Also, I don't use e-collar with her.
Use an e-collar with her. Next. Just you get the thick fur contact points. Who's that whining over there?
Ben. I mean, Blue.
Yeah, Ben. Yeah.
Ben Callahan bonked my dog once for sniffing around near the trash can. Now all I have to do is say no if she gets near it. She promptly moves out of the kitchen and puts herself in a down. Best tool ever.
Look at that. Funny how that works. And all these people are against bonking, but it works. Next.
Kelly, I have fixed so many problems using your methods. However, I can't seem to stop my Cocker Spaniel from turning around and snapping at me when he goes in the crate. Any ideas?
Yeah. Well, number one, because you're using your heart, it's your own dog. Number two, what has been the consequence, and it should be a negative consequence, for that behavior? And it should be something very unemotional but firm. Remember, guys, when I talk about punishment, you're not mad. You're not angry. You're not upset. If anybody's ever seen me train dogs, which they haven't, by the way, if they paid attention, I don't talk. I barely make noise. My seminars I do because I'm teaching. My podcast I do because I'm teaching. But I'm actually working a dog. I am emotionally and energetically, my energy, it's neutral. And it's methodical. So the narrative out there is like, this is like how I train. It's like, no, this is entertainment and I'm trying to deliver information. So when you're correcting your dog, all I know is this. If I had a dog that when I put in the crate tried to bite me, there would be a very firm consequence. And for anybody out there that says, oh my gosh, that's harsh. Really? Why do you think our shelters are filled up with dogs? Why do you think dogs get surrendered? Because they don't do downstays? First of all, how dare your dog do this? Well, maybe it needs to get used to the crate. No, it doesn't. It doesn't. You don't have time for keys to the crate. Why? You've got to go to work today. You've got to go to bed tomorrow. And if it wasn't the crate, it'd be something else. Next. That's kind of crazy. We'll fix that later. Next.
Jane Robinson, how have dog that knows recall with food been using the e-collar with along with here, then food hundreds of times? How do I move away from the food to
stop,
e-collar alone?
Stop using it. Get the dog to punishment. Next.
Sasha, today on a walk with a neighbor's dog ran at me and my dog, I had to hold on to my dog. It was annoying and it is allowed.
So, okay. So I'm not sure where you live.
Is it allowed?
Well, you can do anything you want. Did he use the word we?
She said we dog.
We
ran.
Dog. So you're over in Scotland probably or the UK somewhere, right? So I'm not sure what the leash laws are where you are, but if you're in a leash law area, the dog has to have a leash on. It is okay to kick a dog. Oh my God, that's terrible. Okay? That's terrible. You ready? Hold your spot there. You ready, guys? Good morning, Jeff. I need your advice on a matter. One of my client's dogs was viciously attacked by a dog while he was walking his dog. My client's dog suffered serious injuries to the neck. Furthermore, my client, who is an old man, fell during the struggle and hurt his arm. The dog who attacked was so highly aroused that it took five men who rushed to the aid, beating and attacking the dog to get it to stop and run away. Okay? He wants to know what the proper protocol is. Thank God for those five men. Thank God for the people that would do that. It took five people to get a dog off his dog. Now, I know we're talking about a wee dog, but they can bite your dog too. So these are the questions that I get. So when somebody asks me that question that I get every single day of my life, either by email, on my podcast, and then when I say, you do anything possible, including killing. So I'm about to make a statement. If anybody wants to take that statement and twist it, like everybody loves to twist my words, I'll make it really easy for you. If another dog is attacking your dog and you feel like your dog, you, or the people around you is in jeopardy, it is okay to do anything possible, including killing that dog. Now, if you want to take that statement and go, Jeff kills dogs when he trains them. Like that's what people are doing with my words, by the way. If you haven't seen the videos, that's how things are taken out of context. So we talk about choking out a dog when it's attacking, not when we're training. But all I know is dogs are being killed. Could you imagine being 70 years old or any age? But let's use this example, walking down the street with your dog and all of a sudden an off-leash dog attacks your dog, knocks you over and does not let go. What would you do? What would you do? Oh, I would just, you know, try to break up the dog fight. How? Step by step. Tell me methodically how you do it. Okay, cool. How about if that doesn't work? What would you do? Sometimes you only have a matter of seconds before your dog dies, or your dog is injured, or your child. They're animals. They're dogs. Well, I'm a dog lover. So am I. I love my dog. I love my kids. I value my safety. So this whole conversation out there that like you'd kill a dog, in a fucking heartbeat I would. Wouldn't you? If a dog was trying to harm your dog, wouldn't you? If a dog was biting your kid, wouldn't you? If a dog was latched onto you, wouldn't you? If you wouldn't, man,
That's scary.
Next.
Scattered Storm. Yeah, that was so cool to meet someone in town through your podcast. Having a responsible dog owner with a balanced dog is going to be so cool to train
awesome.
With me.
Awesome.
We plan on allowing them both to meet eventually because they're both balanced and we're both responsible and we've taken it slow.
So proud of you, Scattered Storm. Next.
Monica. Hi, Zoe. Awesome show. Hi.
Awesome. You're doing great, Zoe, by the way.
Norm.
Breathe. You're doing good.
I am breathing.
You're doing good.
Norm Grassfield, making progress with my DA pit lab mix with your videos. Literally couldn't have done it without you. Thanks.
Awesome. Proud of you.
Michael.
And she's also quieting a dog down in the other room.
Trying to.
Zoe, you don't see this, but she's also working this remote at the exact same time. First time on the show, she's training a dog, doing a show, and insulting me. Perfect. Perfect. Everybody wants that job, right?
Michael, you guys rock.
Thank you.
Aldo, can I put my puppy into avoidance in terms of eating her own poop?
Absolutely. Make it suck, or else you'll end up with a poop eater. This whole concept of, the dog, make the poop, give the dog an additive so the poop tastes bad.
Okay.
It's shit. Next. What?
That's really long.
Okay, we don't do the long ones. You guys can't ask long questions. Do an AMA or do a, these are quick. Come on, guys. No long ones.
Next. Jared, good evening. Jeff, how do you teach place from a distance? When I say go place, my dog will go 4 feet in front of me and lay down instead of going to his mat across the room.
So you start it close by, and then you start adding distance. And ideally, you do it on the remote collar, and the dog should know how to turn off the pressure. Next.
Kendra, hey, guys. I've been working with my dog a lot, and I'm looking into taking him off leash.
Okay, cool. So make sure your dog is off-leash trained to the point where it knows that if it bolts, you can get it back. Next.
Kendra, any advice to make it go the best it possibly can?
Yeah, well, I don't know your training skill, and I don't know your dog. But remote collar training for recall is going to be your closest to 100% recall as you can get. Next.
Ari, to work on extending sit stays, should I extend the time between them doing the command and marking it, or the time between making... marking and then release?
You're confusing me. In order to extend it, you start out slow and you add minutes to it, and then you also go, you can say wrong and then put the dog back into a sit. Next.
Steph, how to fix whining for no reason,
bonking is good. Remote collar is the better option. Next.
James, when my dog is in her crate and I walk out of eyesight, she starts whining and barking. How do I address this?
Remote collar. Next.
Holding on, dog training. Hi, Jeff. Welcome, Zoe. You're doing great.
That's
Hi.
Ashley. You'll meet her at the Providence Seminar. She's staying at our Airbnb. She's, because of this show, she gave up smoking.
Nice.
I know.
Congrats.
Next.
Lynn Wilson, recommended brand of e-collar for a Great Dane.
The same one that I've been talking about for the last 15 years. So actually, I haven't for 15 years because e-collar technologies is not that old. Sorry for my reach. So e-collar technology. Okay. We have them on our website. Dog Trail is also really, really good. Next.
Amy Ann, thank you. The hiding behind my knees and switching sides has been frustrating, so I'm glad to know it's good news and I'm not fucking up.
No, it's not. That's the first step that your dog is doing better. Next.
Amy Ann, should I expect this to go away? I'd like neutral over avoidance.
Correct.
This. Okay.
I agree 100%. Step one. Guys, long game. Okay, so you're an alcoholic. You just got out of rehab. Week one, day one, week one, month one. You might not be able to walk down the street with your favorite bar is. Right? You might have to avoid the street, avoid the bar, avoid a restaurant that serves alcohol. Avoid sitting across the table from somebody that's drinking a glass of wine or alcohol. Does it get better? For most people, yes, it does. Next.
Justin McKibben, good resource for determining how much exercise to prescribe for a dog.
We don't prescribe any amount. That all depends on how much time the owner has. I don't know if there's a magic formula for that. So I exercise my dogs a moderate time. I run them and I swim them. So is more better? All depends on how good your turning off skills are. So a lot of people will say, my dog is high drive and I can't get it to slow down. I need to tire it out more. No, you don't. You need to teach it how to do nothing more. So yes, your dog should go for a walk every day, or you should have a run, or the treadmill. If you've got access to water, swimming is fantastic. Absolutely. But most hours of the day, the dog is doing nothing. Teach your dog how to do nothing on command. Next.
Angela Spence, welcome, Zoe. Thank you. Monica, oh my God, so happy bonking. That sucks, does not ruin the dog. I'm competing in the worst bonking category. Yes.
All these people that say you're going to mess up your dog from bonking don't know what they're talking about. Why can I make that statement confidently? Because we actually do the work. And why would I give out somebody information that's going to mess up their dog? Why would I ever do that? Next.
Karen, GSD lover, on the average, how long do you work one-on-one with a dog at training center? My dog loses interest in training after about 15 minutes. Should I keep working them? Thanks. And Zoe, you're doing great.
So So if your dog, if a lot of nervous, fearful dogs, we might keep the sessions short, but you can do 15-minute training sessions, then box your dog up, bring your dog back out, or start going, no, you're going to work more. You're going to work more. Next.
Kate Hopkins, I put my 10-month-old husky in his crate at night to sleep. Lately, he has been whining all night. Can I use e-collar to stop that? It's all right if he wears it all night?
It is all right if he wears it all night. Next.
Murph, hey guys. Hi.
Yeah, you don't want to wear it 24 hours, though. You want to give the dog a break. But when do you use an e-collar at night? When the dog has night problems like whining or barking. Next.
Kim, I'm currently fostering a 5-year-old Sheltie with a neurological disorder. She's horribly afraid of thunder and fireworks. How do I address this?
So you can do a couple of different things. We tend to, some people say, oh, keep the dog busy during those issues. The problem is that means you're there. You have to be there. Some people, what we like to do is teach the dog we teach the dog how to do downer place, and we reinforce that. And if they break that command because of fear, we correct that. So we're not correcting the dog for being afraid. We're correcting the dog for breaking command, and they tend then to get over it. Next.
Julie, dog reactive then. I just asked because our first trainer was a PP and just said she was reactive but didn't explain. She's
right.
Doing really good right. Walking with her prong.
Unfortunately, most force-free or positive reinforcement-only trainers, unfortunately, are not going to give you a proper assessment of your dog. Next.
Ari, what are some things you should keep in mind when training a foster dog versus a personal dog?
It's not your dog. The number one thing is it's not your dog. It's not your job to become emotionally attached to the dog. It's your job to get that dog ready to live in a home where they will be successful. That's the job. So most people are like, oh, the dog needs lots of love and attention and freedom. No, it doesn't. Now, that doesn't mean, it all depends on how we define love. And people love to be like, God, he really doesn't care about dogs. I care about dogs so much, I'm trying to get them to never go to a shelter again. But no dog ever got put down for, like, being structured. Well, I'm sure they do if it's got bad behaviors. That's the wrong statement. But love and affection is one of the worst things to do to a dog that has behavioral issues. Next.
Lynn, I'm obsessed with you and your ways. I'm so proud of myself and my dog, too. We've worked very hard, and absolutely everyone sees my 5-month-old Dade comments on how awesome. Well he listens. I'm awesome. Grateful for you.
Awesome. Listen, who's that?
Lynn.
Lynn, thank you so much for the kind words. Lynn, you're doing the work. I'm proud of you. I'm just the guy with a big mouth. Next.
Hi, guys. My 7-month-old German Shepherd got over my 4-foot garden fence tonight.
Oh,
and
God,
got
yeah.
Out. I've made my peace with having to upgrade to a taller fence, but in the meantime, can do anything to stop him.
Yeah, don't let him out. Keep him on a leash outside. Don't let him out unsupervised. 4-foot fence is nothing. I've got dogs that jump over 8-foot fences. So if we have 4-foot fences, like, I've got a dog that jumps over a 4-foot fence without even touching it. Most German Shepherds can. Next.
Victoria, how do you do client updates during a dog's board and train, text, email, etc.?
We do a phone call once a week. Next.
Kyle, do it. Oh, wait. I already read that. Complete canine category. Thoughts on turning away businesses. My main clientele is aggression, rehab, and very intense dog. I'm turning more people away with puppies and basic training needs, mainly because of my long waiting list.
So what I would do is I would partner up with another trainer in your area that is nice that likes working with puppies. Next.
Random American. My dog is my best friend. What would you do to protect your best friend? My Roddy's name is Zoe.
So exactly. What would you do to protect your best friend? Exactly. Thank you. We're talking about what would you do to kill a dog. Yeah. Next.
Maylene. So any stiffening on walk, any short sort of reactivity, do you immediately shut it down?
Yes. Immediately. It ain't going to get any better. Why wait? Next.
Scattered Storm, glad to hear you're not mad at me. LOL, wanted to ask, do you think allowing him to gain a friend might help him overcome dog fear? When we introduce them, we will be doing butt-to-butt, not face-to-face.
Listen to me. I'm not mad at anybody. So all these people around the world that are throwing all these lies and hate and ill will and death threats against me right now, I mean, it's really bad right now. Like, my family is being threatened. Like, you are the lowest of the low of scum when you threaten somebody's family. It doesn't get much scummier than that. And everybody out there that you have liked a negative comment about me, you're just as responsible, just to let you know. But I don't hate any of these people. I don't hate any of them. None of them do I hate. I don't hate. I have no time for hate. I have no time in my heart. I have no time in my mind for hate. I'm trying to change the world. All I want to do is help more people. So there is no hate. Now, that doesn't mean I won't take action. Like, right now, I'm taking a lot of action. And it's going to surprise people because for 15 years, people have been bashing me and I haven't done a thing. You will never see one comment on any social media platform with me saying anything negative. It does not exist. Now, I might give generalities on my podcast, but all these people that are bashing me, it's like, I get the screenshots. I know who they are. Like, I'm not stupid. And there's two sides to every story. I don't expect an employee that was fired to say nice things about me. I don't expect somebody who was kicked out of my seminar for being very rude to say anything nice about my seminars. I don't expect a client who I literally kicked out of my training space because they were disrespectful to one of my female trainers to say anything nice about me. But I don't hate any of them. Why? That's on them. That's their behavior. All I can say is this. I'm getting more attacks now on my personal safety, my family, my business, my reputation than ever before. I don't hate any of these people. I feel that the internet is exposing a lot of people right now, and they're not exposing me because everything is out there. Everything is out there. I've talked about my whole life. And people need to remember what the sources are. But when a professional dog trainer puts up a comment bashing any other dog trainer, you're always going to get a lot of other dog people or people that are like, yeah, Gellman's an asshole. But you're going to get the other 90% that are going to go, wow, that behavior is really bad. And they take notice. So many people right now are literally, their comment is, I can't stand Gellman. I don't like the way he trains. I think he's loud. I think he's obnoxious. But what you are doing is deplorable. Think about that. And that doesn't go away. That stays up here in a lot of people's minds for a very long period of time. The internet reveals you. If you don't like someone, stop talking about them. And for all these people out there that are saying, oh, Gellman's asking for it? And if you're a female, hashtag me too. Like, you want to go there? I'm asking for it. I'm asking for my family to be threatened for helping people. Really? I'm asking for people to try to put me out of business. I'm asking for it, for trying to help people. And for all the folks out there that are worried that shock collars are going to be banned because of me, you've got it backwards. You have it backwards. Like, shock collars have been banned in countries before I came on the market. When I went over to the UK last year and I sat down with Scottish Parliament as an invited guest, and they wanted to know how they can start regulating shock collars, they asked me. I'm not getting them banned. I'm fighting for every human's right to train the way they want to. It's the people that are sitting silently that are going to get it banned. It is the pure positive trainers that are going to get it banned. It is the people that say they don't do something, but they do, that are going to get it banned. It's the infighting of the balanced community that's going to get it banned. Because I'm not going to get them banned. That's small thinking. And you're not using your mind on that one. You're listening to headlines. You're reading headlines. You're not understanding the information. Stop reading headlines. Know your facts. Know the process. Understand what the person does. Do you know that we do 300 repetitions with clicker and food before we tell a dog the word no and use a higher level stim? Did you know that? That's how we train dogs here. But if you try to put your mouth on me, it's going to suck. Day one. Absolutely. And then guess what? Back to clicker and food. Things are good. We're good. Things go south. We don't get bit. But dog trainers don't want to talk about that. They don't want to admit that. Dog trainers are going, oh, well, dogs wouldn't try to bite you if you didn't push the dog past threshold. You must not understand dog body language. We understand dog body language so good, nobody's getting bit at my company. Nobody needs to wear protective gear to train a dog at my company. Do you know that there's dogs out there that when you walk in a room will charge across the room and bite you? Did you know that? Did you know that if you try to hug your spouse, the dog will bite you? Did you know that if a dog is on the couch and you sit down next to it, that it will bite you? So that's the owner's fault? No, that's the dog. This concept of that dogs are put up on this pedestal, they can't do no wrong, they're animals. They're wild beasts. They use their mouth. And for all the dog trainers out there that are doing what I am doing and jumping on the hate bandwagon, I haven't said anything. But a lot of you are doing that. And that's the most surprising thing. That's the most surprising thing. Because you might be laughing now because it's fun to see me picked on. And guess what? My Las Vegas seminar is almost sold out. The only seminar that's been affected by this is probably Alaska. And I'm still going. But the thing about being a nice person, the thing about putting out massive amounts of value with no obligation of anything in return, the thing about always being kind to people, the thing about treating people well, the thing about serving your industry the right way, is you build this huge tribe of people. This humongous tribe of people. And I don't think people realize how big it is that Sally Canine Training has. because we've helped a lot of people. We've helped a lot of people. So, for all my colleagues out there that are sitting back in silence, maybe it's time to speak up. Maybe it's time for you to say, you know what? I disagree with a lot of what Gellman says, but this is not good. This is not good for our industry. This is not helpful. For all the people out there that are touting themselves as these dog trainers who are like the art of dog training, if someone is using that as a name, it's not you, I apologize. But this bringing dog training to the next level, but you know damn well when a dog tries to attack you, you know what you're doing. You know what you're doing. For everybody in the protection business that chokes out dogs every day, you can't say anything negative. That's what you do for work. That's the job. You better know how to get a dog off a bite. Have you heard any negative response at all from me? Nope. Nothing. I put up a post showing the death threats. That's it. It's very interesting what's happening out there in our industry. It's very interesting. Next.
Kelly Gilly, concerning the snapping when going into crate, I've tried no, then bonker, no, then banging crate, no, then shaking the crate. Maybe my timing is off.
Could be. Get a remote collar on that dog. If that dog ever tried to put its mouth on you, you make it suck. Next.
I lost my place.
Yep, I know. Sorry. That was a rant.
It was.
I'm sorry.
Long one.
I know.
To edit so much out of it.
If anybody, look at you. You're looking like, you got a smile when I'm talking.
It's a smile.
Smile.
It was a serious talk.
Smile more, would you?
I don't want to be smiling when you're having like.
Joelle's laughing her ass off. Next.
I'm sorry. Oh, Cheyenne and Zeke, I'm sorry. It was long. Basically, some guys let this puppy come up to Zeke and got mad that my dog was aggressive, and I yelled at him for having his dog not under control.
Okay. Cheyenne, why couldn't you fucking write that the first time, okay? So, guess what? That's on them, not on you. That's them, not you. You did nothing wrong. Next.
Davis, thank you for your help with Kane. Corso is doing so much better since
awesome.
I started your training.
Proud of you, guys. Next.
Justin, last Q&A, you said during the NCS phase of training, you don't do prompts anymore. You explain this, what you meant by that? What is a prompt?
Okay, a prompt is this. This is a prompt. Let's make it really easy for sit. Say you're doing leash pressure, pressure on, pressure off for sit. Okay? You tell the dog sit. You gently hold the leash up. Dog's head goes up, historically the ass goes down, and then you let go of the leash. Listen, please, everybody out there. He cranks on dogs. Like, right? It's like, do I have to say that before every fucking question now? It's like, you're gently holding it up. So that's a prompt, technically. So you do that a bunch. Eventually, you don't do that. Eventually, you say sit with no leash pressure. The dog sits. You mark it. By the way, it's marked good. Then you can use a food reward or click and good. Now, eventually, after say 100 times, you've stopped, you've said sit, the dog chooses not to sit, then you go back to, okay, leash pressure. The dog sits. So you're still not saying no, you would say wrong. We say wrong. I'm going to do a video on this. Or Brittany's going to actually do the video. She'll say it's wrong, and then leash pressure back up. After 100 times of that, now it's actually fair to go no. Correct, which would be a very firm leash pop. Next.
Kim, can I use a prong collar or e-collar on a 10-pound dog?
Yes, you can, but give me an age, though, after 14 to 16 weeks. Next.
Shanika, my girl is good with her downstay, although worth distraction objects. She will force her neck in a uphold rather than obey at times. What else can I do?
For what, down?
With distraction, see objects. There she
goes. Say that one more time. I'm sorry.
My girl is good with her downstay, although with distraction she objects, she will force her neck in an uphold rather than obey at times. What else can I do?
So what you're going to do, that takes a little bit of time. So distractions mess things up. So ask your, so right now with no distractions, ask your dog to put its head down during the down. Add distractions, the head goes up. Remote collar is going to help with that dramatically. Next.
Oz recording. Hello, Jeff and Zoe. How many bonks a day for a 10-month-old puppy with many bad behaviors? Trash can, bark, leash reactive, door.
Okay, so we barely have to bonk a dog. Nope. So you can address, so dog gets, first of all, why does the dog have so much free space? So how is the dog getting in the trash can, number one? A 10-month-old dog's not a puppy anymore. So dog gets close to the trash can, no, firm bonk. Boom, you're done. Barking, you can use it for that. So the first time you address all these bad behaviors, you can say no and then bonk. All right? But after that, you shouldn't have to bonk really that much at all. Next.
Jared Gordon, I volunteer at a shelter on the weekend. How do you walk a dog the will not move on the leash, not even for treats? Shelter only lets us use a Martin go. Basically have to drag dog out to pee.
Find another place. So first of all, this concept of using food as an incentive, that doesn't work with a lot of the dogs that we get in. And it's not going to work with a shelter dog either. So you're dragging the dog. So I would sit down with the training director and say, this is ridiculous. Which a martingale, guys, look up the patent. It's a limited choke. You're choking the dog. So find another place to volunteer that actually values your time. Next.
Random American answered the question.
Awesome.
Blake Freeman, I have been following your advice for the last 5 months, and my 7-month-old knows the basics, and I have been asked a few times if I am a dog trainer. Makes me feel good. Fuck the haters.
Oh, yeah. But guys, this is not haters. Trust me. I've been getting hate all my life. This is not haters. You go after a man's family, it's not because you're a hater. That's a whole new category. You issue a death threat, you threaten to shoot me, threaten to hang me, threaten to hunt me down, that's not a hater. You have an arrest record a mile long that includes violence, that's not a hater anymore. So this is beyond that. That's why I put it up for the first time ever. Haters, I get those every day. I wake up to hate. Who cares? Big deal. I'm glad you saw my video and my content. Thanks for the comment. Goodbye. Next.
Crystal Lurk, my dog shows dominant behavior towards other dogs, which has gotten him bitten a few times. Should I correct his behavior? This past time he rested his head on another's dog back and the other lunged.
Absolutely. Next.
Scattered Storm, you found an upside to the dog only listening to me when I do out of sight down stays. People tell me when he breaks command and I use the e-collar and call to go back to place.
Awesome. Good job. Proud of you. Louder.
Stephanie Bell, I have a 6-year-old GSD who resource guards me when an e-collar helps.
Yes, practice. It would. I did a video on this. You're teaching the dog out, meaning get out of here. Resource guarding against humans is huge. So we work with a lot of couples who cannot come into physical contact. They can't hug. They can't embrace. They can't talk with their hands. The dog will bite them. So it's out, as in get out of there. The remote collar does it. I've got a video on my YouTube channel that shows exactly how to do that. Next.
Fancy Pants. Hi, Jeff and Zoe. I have a 115-pound cane corso. While walking him today, a 20-pound Don barked at him and scared him. What should I do about it? He is not aggressive, and I don't want him to be. I want him to be respected, LOL. Okay. I walk him with an e-collar.
So switch to get a prong collar. That'll get you more directional control. Getting scared is one thing, but how did the dog rebound from that? So what was the rebound from that? Did the dog go, whoa? And then go, okay, no big deal. So, but prong collar will give you more directional control. Next.
Kyle, thanks, guys. I live in the UK, England, so the limit on garden fences is 6 feet. Hopefully that is tall enough to keep him in.
Yep, so 6-foot fence, keep the dog on a leash. So bottom line is, it's life or death. Make it suck to jump over. Next.
Kim, I have a 9-pound terrier who is very leash reactive to other dogs. Have not been able to shut it down.
So that's skill set. I don't know your skill set at all. But, you know, 9-pound dog, you can use a small prong collar on it. Make sure you're getting the dog in the proper heel. As soon as you start seeing that dog get aroused, pop. That's usually an arousal issue. Next.
Kelsey getting ready to go to PA to visit a friend for a week and debating on taking my ACD. My only holdback is that we have five other dogs who've never met, but she swears aren't dog aggressive. Suggestions?
Yeah, don't take your dog. Next.
Michelle Anderson. It's Michelle. Sorry.
It's okay.
Last Friday podcast, I said I just picked up 9-week-old chocolate lab puppy, sat, mourned, started training. Pup refused food treats Sunday a.m., rushed him to emergency hospital, and he's still there.
Yeah, so I talked to the breeder, and that's probably a breeding genetic issue. 9 weeks old, most likely has something that's beyond my skill set. Next.
Kicking a dead cat.
So first of all, I'm sorry. Next.
Kicking a dead cat. The internet is insane.
Yeah, well, the internet just reveals people. Next.
Kristen, we love you. Jeff, you rock.
Thank you so much.
Michelle Anderson, all signs of
Parvo.
But all test negative. He ate a wee bit tonight for first time. Fuck.
Okay, yeah. I'm so sorry that you're dealing with this. Next.
Shanika, some people are absolutely ridiculous. Just because you disagree with someone or their methods does not mean that you need to threaten them or talk a lot of them. You just have a difference of opinion.
Yeah, but this is the thing. These people, it's not that they disagree. They're just not nice people. See, people need to start understanding the difference. So a lot of people are saying that narrative. Just because you disagree, it's like, they're not disagreeing. They're just not nice people. Always remember, what's the motive? What's the motive? So you have to always figure out, what is somebody's motive? What is somebody's agenda? What's their agenda? That's what you have to remember. Then you can start formulating the information properly. But the thing is that people don't have information. Information will help you with your decision. But nobody's taking the time for that, which is fine. That's why it's on them. All I can say is, nice always wins. So throughout this whole couple of weeks, still being nice, still putting out content, still showing up, still got a long waiting list. Every night, JeffGellmanSeminars.com, still buying tickets. All right? Staff is plugging along. I had a meeting with the staff. Make sure they were all okay. Make sure none of my staff is being affected by this. Personally, emotionally, make sure everybody felt safe. So, making sure that my family is okay and my family at work is okay, because I would kill for them as well. But it's revealing people. It is revealing people. So that's what's really interesting. Remember, agenda. Think, what's the agenda of the person saying something? Next.
T. Culbertson gave $5.
Oh, thanks.
Enrique, Jeff, I love your work. Thanks for all you teach, and I owe you a jump from a plane. Let me know about next trip to Texas or Mexico. Can't wait to meet you.
So I'm going to be in Austin. Check the dates. I forgot when.
September.
November. November. I will come in a couple of days early, and I would love it if you can take Joelle and I skydiving. That would be fantastic, Enrique. And I'd be even more than happy to pay for it, just because having you there, that's worth it. So we'll do, I don't know, what do? You eat after the jump, or you eat before the jump? I don't really care, because I I love that shit. I've never jumped before, but Enrique, if there's the dates and if you're there, I'd love to meet up with you. Thank you.
Julie, thank you.
By the way, he did a $50 Mexico money. Next.
Julie, thank you, Jeff, for clarifying the reactive thing. I knew it was dog and not leash, but I wanted to hear you.
Yep, sorry. Yep.
By the way, I don't use the PP trainer any longer, so huge thanks for us advocating for your dog and you for all your help.
Yep, my pleasure. Remember, guys, people say, what do you think about clicker training? Well, or positive reinforcement training. How do you think we get dogs to do things?
Yep, every day.
Every day. That's all we do. All day long. That's it. But we have a brand new employee, Nicole, second day on the job, guess what she learned? Her first, one of the first things she spent the first day, it's going to be weeks of this, but the first thing she's learning is how to stay safe. So she took Timber out. Timber's that black German shepherd who bites. She has to take him from his kennel to the potty yard. And I made sure she knew how to keep herself safe.
She actually corrected him today, too, because he tried to climb up on her.
Yeah. And you don't need to wear gear like bite suits and gauntlets and like, you know, you don't need to wear all this gear working with these dogs because you learn how to read them. But that doesn't mean they're not going to bite you. They'll bite you for, you can be walking a dog outside the door to go to the bathroom. That dog might see a speck of like dust or whatever, a speck of anything on the ground and go, oh, I think I want to sniff that. And you might be like, we're going outside now. And that dog will go, oh, no, we're not. Boom, bite you. You better know what to do. Staff's not getting bit here. Now, did I get bit at the beginning of my career? Absolutely. Why? I didn't have this knowledge. Next.
Kelsey, to all the people who keep talking shit about you that don't understand, it's just advertisement for you, LMAO, because they're just going to lead more people who need you to them.
Yeah, I mean, so I've often said I love it when people do that. And I will say that I've often said that I love it when people pass out my videos and bash me. Absolutely. This is a little bit differently, but I will also say our social media presence has skyrocketed. You know, believe it or not, our business will do great, but still the bottom line is the narrative now is, because it's true, you cross the line. You fuck with my family. That's it. End of story. End of story. Linda's a fucking homemaker. We homeschool our kids. Like, what are you, fucking nuts? So this is different. So this is a little bit different. Next.
Shanika, I love your work and your methods are super effective. Plenty of positive, amazing testimonies. Enough said.
Oh, yeah. I don't give a shit. Yeah. I mean, I give a shit about your comment. What I'm saying is, this ain't going to stop us. Trust me. And by the way, if someone does Rhode Island SPCA, R-I-S-P-C-A, R-I-S-P-C-A, one phone call to them, they'll come flying down to my door. So for all the folks out there that think I am ruining dogs or abusing dogs, Rhode Island SPCA, that's who you call. Like, wouldn't it? Like, if you're really thinking somebody's abusing dogs, wouldn't you call the people that actually can do something about it? So, my corporation, my staff, we are overseen by the state of Rhode Island. Like, there's eyeballs on us 365. We have licensing here. We actually have a license. Like, we have to be held accountable. We have to do proper record keeping. Dogs have to have certain shots. We get inspected to make sure that our place is, we abide by health codes. Like, I don't think people understand, like, what we do. So, next.
Dre Sims, Jeff's Monday's rant. Yes.
Yeah, that was a good one. And I know, and I hate this because I don't want this to be too ranty. Am I being too ranty?
No, you're good.
You sure?
Yeah.
All right.
We'll see when I get clips later.
I'll ask Joelle. Let's see, Joelle. I haven't gotten an email from Melissa or Joelle saying, Jeff, shut the fuck up. So, next.
Kathy McGinley, I've been a fan for years. I just don't know what's been going on with all this negative online crap. How did this all start? I've been off social media for a while. What has happened?
No, there's just somebody likes to doctor a bunch of... People love to put hate videos together and put them out there. Enough said. Next. Let's move on.
Riley Gordon. Hi, Jeff and Zoe. Toy poodle is going through some chronic attentions seeking behaviors. Should the owner correct the behaviors or countercondition this massive amounts of structure and obedience?
You can do step one first, correct it. Step two, countercondition next.
Luck and charm. Your strong and kind energy is a gift. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Judy, tools are necessary. Training any animal, try a 12,000, 1,500 pound horse who has a bit habit of rearing while leading.
Yes.
Just to name one issue, can't train bratty attitudes with carrots.
That's true. Yeah, horse people know. Horse people are good at this stuff. Next.
Kim, love you, Jeff. Love your family. Love your staff.
Thank you. Next.
Ranch, Rach. Wow, Joelle, you look different. Thank you.
She does.
Kristen, I got a tan.
That's right.
Hey,
she's going to come back with a tan.
She's going to come back with a tan.
I think she's going to beat you on the tan.
Maybe.
I think so.
Christine Moose, Gellman Balance Trainers would not take issue with you, period. End of story. IMHO, it's an organized campaign to discredit you. You are revealing their incompetence.
In my humble opinion, yep.
Yep. So you are revealing the agenda.
Yep, it's true. It's true. The internet, this is what people don't understand. The internet reveals you. It's just that people don't get it. They just don't get it. The internet reveals you. Next.
Murph, I found your podcast by chance 2 months, and you've literally changed our lives for the better just by watching your video/podcast. I'm beyond thankful for who you are.
Murph, I'm beyond thankful for you for being a fan. Next.
Scattered Storm. Okay, Jeff, thanks for the rant, but you didn't answer my question, LOL.
Shit. What was your question?
I don't remember.
Shit.
Sorry.
The last I heard from you was butt-to-butt greeting. Yeah. And so it's like, okay, sure, go ahead. Next.
Madison Allen, if there's any better feeling than doing a smooth left about turn with no leash pressure required, thanks for all you do.
Isn't that beautiful? I know. Moving with your dog, isn't that beautiful to do? That's a great exercise and it's a lot of fun. Next.
Scattered Storm. Also, my dog has started humping every once in a while, but not on anything and doesn't seem to understand what he's doing, so I've resorted to not correcting him until he seems to know what he's doing. What?
Scattered Storm. What are you, fucking nuts? Correct the damn dog. Use your remote collar. We use a stockyard whip, but use your remote collar. Next.
Ariel, in what situations would you use comfort pads or winged pads on the dog's e-collar?
Comfort pads are really good for dogs that have got short-haired dogs with skin abrasions or with skin sensitivity or have got a metal issue.
Allergies,
yep. The winged pads are good just for better contact sometimes when you're longer for dogs. Next.
I'm relating it to the tweens not realizing they need deodorant. He's 10 months.
Oh. Okay.
Kim, my dog has neurological issues, won't go up the stairs. She puts on the brakes and starts spinning in circles. What can I do to help her go up
Kim,
the stairs?
Kim, I'm not going to address the neurological issues, but let's say this. How about this? Let's get rid of the first sentence. Kim, my dog doesn't go upstairs and spins. Let's just stick with that. Leash on, make it a prong collar. You at the bottom of the stairs. You holding the leash. I want you to say, let's go, walk, stair by stair by stair by stair. Get to the top. Ready? Turn around. Let's go. Walk down, stair by stair by stair by stair. Down at the bottom, do it again. Repeat that 3 or 4 times. Guess what? Your dog will walk up those stairs. Spinning around, any OCD behaviors, that's great for bonking. Neurological disorder or not, it doesn't matter. Who said your dog has a neurological disorder? And it might. But guess what? It can still walk up steps. Next.
Lynn Wilson, before Jeff, I was anti-prong until the video that explained the tool could whisper or yell.
Yep.
Nobody ever explained it that way. I thought it was all pain until your video and the prong dance.
Yep. And folks think I'm destroying the industry. Nope. Next.
Jay Kwok. Tips to get 15-week GSD to be calm when someone like my dad says, Mom, go over to pet her. She gets overly excited, aroused with people that aren't her main handlers.
Right. So that happens often. So what? This is the thing. You definitely want your dog to be handled by as many people as possible right now in age. So what you could do is really, really work highly on always sitting for attention. Sitting for attention. For an overly aroused dog, even a puppy, we would bonk the puppy, though, for over-arousal, believe it or not. Next.
Jared Gordon, my dog only barks when someone knocks at the door. When we're home, if no one's home, people can knock on the door all they want and he won't make a noise. Any reason for this or ideas how to stop it?
No, well, the how to stop the non-barking? No, that I don't know how to do. But how to stop? But I don't mind a dog barking once if you're home. What you can do is just say no and correct the dog. Now you have to find a way to correct it. So remote collar, bark collar, bonker next.
Sue Palmer. Hi, Jeff. My miniature schnauzer won't stand up once I put the prong collar on. Suggestions?
Yep. So, Sue, your dog, we've seen this with dogs with every collar, slip lead. So, do my north, south, east, west. So, what you're doing is pretend you're going north, even though it's not due north. That doesn't work. Go back south. That doesn't work. Head east. That doesn't work. Head west. That doesn't work. Repeat. At some point, your dog's going to go. And then also be applying a little bit of leash pressure. A little bit of leash pressure. Once that dog starts movement, boom. Turn around and start heading north again. Next.
K9W dog training. So true. Please tell them and never stop.
I'm not stopping, guys. I'm not stopping at all. Next.
Christine Moose. Gellman, don't jump out of a perfectly good airplane.
Christine, I love to travel. I love to fly. I've never gone skydiving before, but Enrique wants to take me skydiving. I'm going skydiving.
You'll have to film that, like, somehow.
Enrique's got everything. Okay. Enrique... Did you get married on a jump? Did you get married on a jump? The stuff that he shows, it's like, it's beautiful.
Gotta check it out.
I think he belongs to like a skydiving team or a club. Mm-hmm. And it's just really, really beautiful what the stuff he's doing. He's also, I think he's a big dirt biker. He's definitely an adventure, adrenaline junkie. Next.
Balance Pack Canine Training. Hi, Jeff. Do you know about the Esky e-collar? Is it crappy? If a client already has it, should I still make them get the mini educator?
I've never heard of that brand. We required them to have a decent remote collar. And we only train on dog chart or e-collar technology just because of the way that our timing works on everything. Next.
We made the mistake of loving our rescue too much. Nope. Thank you for all the free training, lifesaver for us and the dog.
No problem at all. Next.
Bitless Equestrian. Hey, do you have a video on teaching the out command? I know you said out, then tap on the e-collar, but my pup doesn't know which way to go. Any tips?
Yes, leash pressure. Use leash guidance. There you go. Next.
Melanie, we're making great progress. We'll be able...
Awesome. And you can, don't worry, you can still save, you'll be fine. You didn't fuck up the dog. Next.
She asked, will we be able to train out our mistakes?
Yes, you can.
Oh, man.
I know you got jumped again.
Todd Tudden.
Yep.
Welcome, Zoe. Jeff, I missed the rant. Could you repeat it? No, he cannot repeat it.
Here we go. Ready?
30 more minutes.
Next.
Any tips for combating anxiety and encouraging some confidence in the elderly dog who is losing his vision?
Ooh, yeah. Well, blind dog, I would make sure you can use scents in certain rooms. So like certain doorways can have different scents in them. Believe it or not, dogs do really well without vision. They do really well without vision. As far as confidence, was that the first thing for the confidence?
Encouraging some confidence.
Confidence, yeah. So what with confidence, leash on the dog and just do training, hold the dog accountable, and then do under, over, through things. Do that. Next.
Vanessa, hi guys. I follow all your techniques. My 7-month-old puppy does great on walks, crate, hikes, but when I take her to the dog park, she is so stressed she vomits. How can I calm her dog at the park?
Vanessa, dog parks are terrible. Don't go to the dog park, ever. And if you want to know why, I will let the audience chip in. Next.
Great communicator. Got Basin Shepherd mix in September. Only
Basenji.
I
you know what a Basenji is?
Nope. Basenji.
If you ever want a dog that doesn't bark, get a Basenji.
Mix in September. Only trained using your vids. Made all difference in the world. I tell it all dog owners about you. Keep it up.
Thanks. I'm not going anywhere, guys. I'm not stopping. Next.
Karen GSD lover, I have a long coat dog and use the comfort pad with wings on a bungee e-collar. Love it.
Yep, awesome.
Jamie Braxton, how can I get my dog to calm down when daddy comes home from work? I have her in place and she starts shaking like she's going to explode and then flies off the cot once he enters the door. Can't control herself.
Okay, so the shaking is the excitement. Let the dog do that. It's that flying off. Put the dog on a back tie. And what you're going to do is correct the dog for breaking place. correct the dog. So take, is it her husband that comes in?
Yes.
So husband comes in, ignore the dog. What I want you to do is hold that dog accountable. So what you're doing is you're not correcting the dog for being happy to see dad. You're correcting the dog for breaking a known command. I'm going to assume the dog knows the command because you said the dog's in place. Next.
Shanika, my cane Corso has dramatically improved. She doesn't break a stay command. Should I tie her up? Go into the store for 2 minutes, constantly barking, and this is a separation anxiety.
No, it's I really struggle with the concept of leaving a dog outside of a place of business and going into a store. I really struggle with that. I really do. I just struggle with that. I mean, I would technically the dog should have a remote collar on, and you can correct it. But so, like someone can just grab your dog. I mean, I struggle with that. Next.
Tokage, something non-dog. My daughter told me, Mama, whenever I feel a little scared at night, I put on Jeff's podcast. I listen to his voice and there's nothing left to be afraid of. Yeah, because he scares you. I'm kidding.
Fuck you. He's Toka, that's like...
That's cute. One of
cute. I was about to cry.
Oh, my bad.
You're bad is fucking right. You're bad.
Sorry.
Jesus Christ. Tokaj, tell your daughter I love her. Thank you so much. And it's okay to be afraid, but don't ever let it stop you. You can tell your daughter that I'm afraid every day. Okay? I'm afraid of a lot of things. Well, the number one thing is I'm afraid I can't provide for my family. That's my number one fear. My number one fear is I'm afraid I can't provide for my family. Because that's it. It's me. It's me. It's all my family has. So, next.
Mark Evans, I have a 125-pound Dane. Really have great control with prong collar. She can be very bullish, and the other collar makes it all better. I have tried it on myself, too.
Yeah. Mark, and this is the thing. I don't try any collars on myself. Well, I put up a shock collar on myself just for, like, you know, I did that back in my radio days just for, like, internet bullshit. But... yeah, there's no reason to do it. It's a dog. You're like, who's tasting their dog's dog food? Who's doing vet checks like a dog gets a vet check? Right? Who's walking around barefoot in the middle of the winter? You know, so who's walking around naked? Half my audience is going,
hey,
me. Next.
Swedish canine lover. Hi, Jeff and Zoe. Is it possible to add translation text to other languages to some of your videos, especially them where you are explaining tools, because they're really good? We're working on it.
Yeah, working somehow. On it. So, Melissa, can you look into that, please? Next.
Bitless Equestrian. I'm so, so happy I found your videos. My new dog, Stark, I've only had for 3 weeks. He's already amazing on recall.
That's impressive. Next.
Riley Gordon, Jeff, you should start a podcast called Jeff's Rants. They're the best.
I can't, because my rants aren't planned.
Nope.
They're never planned. I can't stop. You know, it's like, people like, you should stop saying fuck so much. Like, it just comes out. It just comes out so much. I just can't help it sometimes. And it's like, people are like, do you swear around your kids? I'm like, all that. Angelo comes to work with me. Do you do what you were? He doesn't even want to leave work.
No, he never wants to leave.
I'm like, Angelo, we got to go now. What?
Why?
I want to live here.
I'm still working.
He did a shitload of freaking videos,
he did
right?
A lot today. I have to check them out.
You know what I'm doing? If he's, can you put together today? If there's like a, you don't have to make them long, but if there's a bunch of clips that he videoed, just make a little
compilation.
A little. Angelo's video. Was he on the gimbal today?
Yeah, and everything.
Just do something. Do something. Yeah, it doesn't even have to be like start to just like anything. Anything. Next.
Bitless Equestrian, the e-collar has been a lifesaver. Thank you so much for your free content.
You're welcome. Next.
Scattered Storm, Parvo at the dog park. Woo!
Yeah. Woohoo! Yeah, I would stay out of the dog park. It's really bad.
Teresa, hey Zoe, welcome. Hey Jeff, hope you both are having a great night. Vanessa, many reasons not to go to the dog park. Long story short, many owners don't train their dogs or have control or watch them.
Yeah, so things are great. Thank you. I'm having a great night. How about you, Zoe? You doing okay?
I'm doing good. I feel better now that I did it already.
Good. Next.
Diana, Doberman rescue guards me somewhat. He goes to place consistently, no problem. However, he is on alert, stares instantly when family members in room. Can I correct with E-car?
Absolutely. Absolutely. This is the thing. It's like, well, that's a breed specific. I got German Shepherds and I got a Malinois. The last thing I want them to do is to be guarding me. Nobody's trying to hurt. Well, I shouldn't say that. I can't say that anymore. People actually want to. But this is the thing. Nobody's trying. I'll just make a general question. Nobody's trying to hurt you. Your dog's going to end up biting your best friend, your roommate, Uncle Joe. Uncle Joe's a dick, though. Okay.
Sometimes.
Uncle Joe, he touched you inappropriately. Uncle Joe deserves to be bit. So, say it.
What?
Uncle Joe should be bit.
Uncle Joe should be bit.
See that? So, all right, next.
Fabulous Unicorns. Hi, Jeff. I started teaching my dog Place with a remote collar this week, and she does well 15 minutes or so, and then stops being compliant, trying to run away from the stim. Any advice?
Yes, you're taking it. I don't know your skill set. You might be moving too fast. Next.
Kristen, can you use something other than a cot for Place, a mat or pillow?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. So Place can be any surface, any area, anything you can send the dog to, and you can also move it around. Next.
Tokaj gave 3 thumbs up.
Thank you, Tokaj. He's the one that had the story about his daughter.
I know. I ruined it. I'm sorry.
You didn't ruin it.
Well, you didn't cry. It would have been a good, You
royally fucked it up. Not the me crying, but why do you have to be so uncaring? People were just starting to like you, and then you have to like make fun of someone's daughter crying. You made fun of a child being afraid.
I have sisters. I'm fine.
She was when I first met her, we Skyped a lot. She took care of her younger sisters. What's your mom's name?
Yvette.
Yvette, do you know that? You know that she was. Do you know how cold and uncaring she was?
She knows. She knows.
I know. I remember when I was Skyping with you to like talk because Zoe started doing video stuff with us before, like 2 months before.
2 months.
2 months before. She just turned 18 years old. Well, you came here at 17.
Yeah, I came here at 17.
You celebrated your 18th birthday.
Yep.
I know.
The second week I was here.
That's right. But you took care of your every day. Did you do
every
it
every day?
Every day,
Monday through Friday.
From what? How many hours?
From 11 a.m. to 6 sometimes.
Did you
7?
Really?
Yeah.
So your mom could be at work.
Yeah.
Nice.
She's working.
That was so nice of you. That
See, I can be nice. Okay. I just don't. Kids are not my thing.
Shit. I'm gonna tell Angelo to stay away from you.
No. Angelo, I like Angelo. He has like a really like big brain. Like I could have like a real conversation with him. My sisters, it's like, can I play with this?
If you try to talk to Angelo like a 6-year-old,
it doesn't work.
He will look at you. He will actually say something. He'll actually be like, he won't. What's he gonna say? Well, his last name is Gellman. Oh, so he'll say, "What are you, a fucking idiot?" So, but he's like, he actually can have an in-depth
conversation
with you about a lot of stuff. He also has a photographic memory. He also does math the way I do math, but he can see numbers floating around in the... have you ever done any math stuff with him?
No.
Do some math stuff with him.
Try it tomorrow.
Do something like this. Angelo, if there is 4 dogs and each dog got 3 cups of food, how many cups of food would we need? Just make up those numbers.
Okay.
He'll give you the answer.
Like right away or just like a second?
He doesn't know 4 times 3. Mm-hmm. So he has not memorized math tables. He understands the process. And he envisions the numbers. Mm-hmm. Like he literally can see them floating around. And like, I don't know if your brain works that way.
No.
You, what you do is you can see them moving around and you can actually move numbers around in the air. He sees the math equation in the air and then he will give you the answer. It's really beautiful to watch. Yes.
Gotta try it, though.
Yes. Ask him. Ask him some stuff like that. Yeah.
Jamie Braxton, I have a 4-pound dog who lips her lips the entire Licks
her
time.
Lips.
She's playing with my daughter's dog, who is larger than she is. Is this something bad?
Yeah, leave it alone. Next. Just watch out for the big dog, the size and difference, and the dog doesn't get squashed. Next.
Cherise, Angelo's highlight reel, starting that portfolio young. Can't wait to see it.
Yeah, I'm going to make an Instagram. You want to make an Instagram account for him?
Oh, we said we would do it.
Like
we just haven't done it.
You have nothing but you don't have enough to do. Yeah. Yeah.
Ari Sharp, I'm crying. I put Jeff's on too when I need a confidence boost.
Ari, I love you, honey. Ari, how many times did you go to the gym this week? Well, it's Monday. The last 5 days, Ari, how many times have you been to the gym? Let me know. Next.
Random American. A place can be anything that separates a dog from the ground, a mat, bed, crate, correct, etc.
Yep.
Amy Ann, dog parks are full of dogs who owners can't control them.
Historically, yep. And
balance pack canine training. You're sure yelling at Zoe a lot. It's nothing new.
Am I yelling at you a lot?
No. I'm just kidding. Yep. Teresa, teaching one of the founders, Seth Foster's, at the shelter night and had Ragnar in place using the e-collar the entire class. Separation anxiety is getting better since our Skype as well, slowly and steady.
Awesome, Teresa. Proud of you. Next.
Cheyenne and Ziki, a little chihuahua has been terrorizing the neighborhood, and every time it comes near my house, I stomp and get it away. It tried peeing on my dog's fence, and I had to smack it to keep it away.
Yeah, yeah. We live in a neighborhood where there's a lot of chihuahuas, too. Man, I see these chihuahuas cry. The other day, Linda was driving home down our Mount Pleasant Avenue, and all of a sudden, a chihuahua ran in front of her car. And it's our neighborhood, man. So we got loose chihuahuas everywhere. Next.
Chihuahuas on the run.
Yep.
Jules Canio. Hey, guys. Jeff, I have been listening to you for almost a year now. Excited to get to work with my 10-week-old Doberman puppy. Tips on using daily meals as a reward when feeding
So 10-week-old puppy, it's all the dog's daily food. Take the allotted amount of food you're going to do, put it in a food bag. You do everything. So some good exercise is recall. So recall, sit, break. So started introducing down maybe, you know, week two, unless the dog's really offering it, but you're going to be doing, go in and out of your crate, sit, recall, down, place, all high drive. Don't worry about, not high drive, excitement stuff. Don't worry about duration. Next.
Kenneth Stevens. Hey, Jeff, thank you for all the free content. You're funny as hell. And if my male GSD is on his cot and he does a little growl when my female GSD walks by him, he does it a few times a week, bonk or And nick him.
I would nick. Just no and then nick. Next.
Karen GSD lover. I'd love to see Angela's math process.
You missed Ari's.
Ari Sharp. Three.
In 5 days?
Oh, three. Oh, that's what I was like. I was like, Ari? She said three.
Ari, that's good. But you know what, Joelle? What's Joelle going to say?
Need more.
What's she going to say? How about the other two? That's what she's going to say. But that's fine. Ari, I'm proud of you. Joelle, that's who you got to answer to, though. She's a slave driver. Next.
Karen GSD lover, I'd love to see Angelo's math process in action on IG, please. Have a great night, guys.
Sure. I'll do it. We'll do something.
We'll do something tomorrow.
We'll do something next.
That's it?
We're over time. All right, guys. Madly in love with you. Everybody's doing great. For all the folks that are messaging me, and you know, stuff, and then also, you know, reaching out and wanting to know how my family is doing. Thank you so much. Everything is great. We're putting up more amounts of content. I got Mackenzie sent me a bunch of stuff I've got to go through tonight. I've got to do that. Question for the replay viewers. If you're watching the replay, so don't answer it now because you're watching it live. If you're watching the replay of this, and you'll know it's the replay because there's a thumbnail that Melissa made that looks different than my thumbnail. It'll be up in about 2 days. If you're watching the replay, what's the question for the replay viewers is, what's the easiest bad behavior to correct that your dog has had? What bad behavior was easiest for you to correct, and how did you do it? That's the question. Jeff Gellman of Sally Canine Training, I am madly in love with you. I'm honored and blessed. Remember, nice always wins. Zoe, congratulations.
I made it.
You made it to your first one. You're going to do Wednesdays, right?
Yep, I'll do Wednesdays.
And then should we put Nicole on the hot seat for...
Maybe Saturday.
I'll do Friday.
Or Friday, whichever one works. Maybe.
Maybe.
Got to ask.
We'll see. She might not have warmed up yet to us yet. We'll see. All right. Madly in love with you guys. Take care. Bye-bye.